Hi all, good morning to everyone. So welcome to the session on introduction to digital marketing. So in this webinar, what we are going to learn, about what is digital marketing, why digital marketing is important, difference between traditional and digital marketing, future scope of digital marketing, growth statistics of digital marketing in India, different fields of digital marketing, opportunities in digital marketing, and then we will study about roles and responsibilities of digital marketer, digital marketing jobs available in India, and then what are the core skills required for a digital marketer, and then we will study about digital marketing career tree. So first we will understand what is digital marketing. So now all of you have heard about now online marketing. So earlier marketing means what they used to do, they used to promote like their business, a product or a service through the like print media, TV, or maybe newspaper or holdings. So now by using digital marketing, so now what we do means we will use the digital channels. Digital channels means like social media, maybe mobile applications or web applications or email. So digital marketing, it is nothing but we will use the digital technology to promote and market our products or services. So it will be like using the digital channels. Okay, so it is nothing but we will use the digital channels to promote and market our products or services by using like search engines, email, web applications, websites, etc. So this is the digital marketing. So now we'll understand like why we need digital marketing, because we have earlier that traditional marketing is there, then why we need this digital marketing. So here we will be having more potential customers compared to traditional marketing, and it is cost effective and miserable. So like I will explain like how we will get more customers. In a traditional marketing, what used to happen, suppose for example we will take a holding. So here every customer will come. Here we cannot target specific people, so everyone will see the ads, but nobody will, we can say it, he is a potential customer. We cannot decide like he is going to purchase our product or service, but in digital marketing we can specifically target the people. So in this case we can say potential customers, so we can easily recognize that he is the one who is going to buy our product or service. So we can easily recognize our potential customers. So recognizing of potential customers in digital marketing will be like more, like we can have more potential customers than in traditional marketing. And the results here are miserable. So we can measure the results like you may be clicks, likes, shares. So like that we can measure. So like now other benefits of the digital marketing are, here we can interact with our prospects. Now prospects is nothing but same thing again. It's nothing but a potential customer. So as I earlier said, so the potential customers means what? The customer who is really interested in our product or service. So that customer we call it as potential customer or prospect. So and so here we can interact with him. Okay, we have like Facebook and we have like Instagram or WhatsApp is there. So easily we can interact with him. So and then we can understand what the customer is like want. So then ability to reach a global marketplace. Earlier in traditional marketing, what happens? It will be specific to a local area. Okay, any shop is there, anything is there, it will be restricted to a locality, one locality. But by using this digital marketing, we can reach to a global marketplace. So a person sitting in a remote village, okay, so he can do business in US also. So next, what is the factor? Like you can save money and reach more customers for less money than the traditional marketing methods. So now here, the earlier for traditional marketing, we need to spend crores of rupees. Okay, so but here the whatever for this digital marketing we are spending compared to the traditional marketing, it is less. So we can save the more money and we can reach to more customers. So this we will study further, like how we can reach more customers. As you know, like internet usage is increasing day by day. So through that we can reach to more customers. And then we can get to know our audience and allow them to know you personally, which can help to create brand loyalty. So now we have presence in like Facebook, Instagram. So customers, they will see our profiles. They will see our about like our products and services in Facebook, WhatsApp, and all. So by this, we can increase our brand loyalty. And then is you can track responses to your marketing efforts immediately. So in this one, how we can track means like maybe it may be likes or the shares, okay, or maybe the like responses we are getting. So based on that one, we can track the responses. And then you can track the performance of your competitors. So maybe you can like your competitors are there. So you can track their performances also. ROI. ROI means return on investment. So it can be measured easily. The government of India, another factor is, okay, the government of India, you all may be knowing that they are pushing for digital India. Okay, so one of the major project of Mr. Prime, our beloved Prime Minister Narendra Modi is like improved online infrastructure and the increase in internet activity. Okay. So from this we can conclude so why the digital marketing is in like it is important. So now let us understand like difference between traditional and digital marketing. So traditional marketing means what? It involves a presence on print ads, okay, outdoor ads, that is the holdings, and the newspaper ads, and the TV, and the radio. So earlier we used to use these channels, okay? But nowadays for digital marketing, what we are using a website, okay, email, social media, search engine. So these tools we are using. So this is the first difference. The second difference is lacks a specific targeting of prospects. So in traditional marketing, we cannot target specifically, as I told, right? If it is a holding is there, okay? But everyone will watch that ad, but we cannot decide like, we cannot target, oh yes, this is my customer. But in digital marketing, we can specifically target people based on their location, their gender, their age. Okay, so we have something called as Google Ads. So in that it has given one option. So based on location, we can target. Based on gender, we can target. Based on age also we can target. Okay, you people will be like seeing like sometimes you will watch one, suppose you search for laptops, you will see that ad like, okay, when you search something like laptop you have searched, but after some days you will be getting an ad of laptop. So why you are getting it is so it is because of the this technology. So it will see like this customer is searching for laptop. So now it goes to that technology, that means Google, it will understand the, your behavior, then it will start triggering those ads only, those in which you are interested. So this is what we can specifically target people. The next point is the traditional marketing, it is static. We cannot interact with the people, okay? But in the digital marketing, we can interact with the people, we can respond to them, and we can share messages to them. We can understand what they want and what's their need. So this is the like difference. The next one is our traditional marketing is it's costlier compared to digital marketing. So in digital marketing, it's cost effective. So you only pay when the audience views or interacts. Okay. So this will be in Google Ads. So when you are you click on the ad, then only you will be charged. Here the in traditional marketing, the as I said, reach is local. So only bigger brands can afford the global reach. But digital marketing, so any person, okay, any person sitting in anywhere, he can reach to anywhere. He can do like a person sitting in India can do business in US also. So you may be heard like drop shipping and all affiliate marketing. So through that we can like reach to global place. And in traditional marketing, the direct results are not measurable. But in our digital marketing, we can measure the results such as clicks, okay, maybe views, impressions, and conversions. So this is a difference between traditional and digital marketing. Now let us understand what is the future scope of digital marketing. With the rising influence of internet networking, digital marketing is guaranteed to observe an upward tendency. Now all people may be knowing like the internet activity is day by day increasing. After Corona, it again gained more of that one. So analytics and statistics suggest that 40% growth rate for digital marketing, while that for other industries, it is 5 to 10%. So in coming economic year, this rate is going to be multifold. So now at the same time, the demand for digital marketing experts and the professional who got the training certification in digital marketing, so they are going to rise. So now let us understand the digital revolution in India. So now the Google has invested 33,737 crore rupees in Jio industry. So for what purpose it will? So it invested because it wants to develop 5G technology. Thereby, it wants to give affordable smartphones. Okay, earlier it has given the affordable internet. So now it has planning to give affordable smartphones. Okay. So now the Facebook also invested. How much it has invested? It is 43,574 crores. So it has got like 9.9% stake in India's Reliance Jio platforms. So this also now from this also you can see the how the digital revolution is happening in India. Now Indian OTT, okay, platform. So you all may be watching Netflix is there, Amazon Prime, right? So it is now the market is going to reach $5 billion by the end of. Like 2023, and edutech revolution has also started in India, as many investors are investing in online education. So online education like such as Baiju is there, okay, Unacademy is there, okay. So edutech revolution is also happening. Now according to a report, Indians living in cities now spend their more time like more than 4 to 6 hours they are spending on the mobile only or on internet. So before what they used to do, they used to do read newspaper, okay, they used to watch TV, but now slowly all of them are moving towards this social media, YouTube, so almost all are moving towards internet. So now this one you know, like 4G introduced by Jio, so how the digital revolution happened. So once the Jio has started that affordable internet activity, internet they have provided, so it has gained. So it has changed the full picture only. So now from there onwards, everybody is using now internet. So now in 2020, India had nearly 700 million internet users. So now by 2025, so it is going to be reaching 974 million users. So this indicates the big market potential for the internet services. So as the internet increases, so it is directly proportional to our digital marketing. So definitely we are going to have a more scope for digital marketing. So in fact, India was ranked as the second largest online market worldwide in 2019. So after China, it is the second largest internet user. So this is the graph. It will show how it is going to increase the internet users. In 2015, it will become 302. In 2016, it will reach 342. So by 2025, it is going to reach 975 million users. So with 5G technology, internet users will be able to download significant data. Okay, so 5G now, as I earlier said that Google invested, right? So they are now producing affordable smartphones. So 5G technology is coming. The increased time spent on digital medium set the stage for enormous growth in digital advertising. So from all these points, you can say the future or what is the scope of digital marketing will be booming high. Yeah. So these are some growth statistics of digital marketing in India. So in 2019, digital advertising saw an increase of 26% compared to 2018. So which is equivalent to 13,683 crore. So now in 2019, India's digital media market was assessed to be 221 billion Indian rupees. Now by the end of 2019, the overall Indian advertising industry's value was at 68,475 crore. In 2021, the industry is expected to grow by 10.9% to reach 75,952 crores. So in the year 2021, the number of mobile phone internet users in India has reached 448 million. So on an average, the country's digital media industry was estimated to show a steady hike of 23%. It's compounded annually between 2018 to 2021. Now the given estimate is projecting it to cross 414 billion rupees by 2022. So now at the end of 2025, so digital this industry will grow at a CAGR of 27.4% to surpass the 50,000 crore mark. Now we'll different fields of digital marketing. So here you can see search engine optimization is there, search engine marketing is there, social media marketing, content writing, email marketing is there, blogging, affiliate marketing, digital marketing analytics. In the search engine optimization means it will be giving you organic results. Here you no need to pay anything, okay? Whereas search engine marketing means you will give some amount, okay, to you, like maybe Google you will give, or Google ads is there, Facebook ads is there. So these all comes on, and Instagram ads is there. No, we need to give to them, okay? So Google ads, Facebook ads, and then comes Instagram ads. So these all comes under search engine marketing. And next one is social media marketing. Same thing for organic, we have Facebook is there, Instagram, and then content writing. So here we will create the content, and we will post it in different websites and in different social media channels. Then email marketing. So it is also one of the field for digital marketing, where we will take the customers' emails and we will start doing marketing. Next one is blogging. So blogging means here you will pick one hot topic, you can say, or the trending topic. Based on that one, you will create the content and you will post it in social media, you can say. It will be one website is there. So there you need to create some articles, and daily you need to post. Then affiliate marketing is there. Affiliate marketing means you need to sell another company's products or services. On that you will get some commissions. So digital marketing analytics means here you need to analyze the data. You need to understand how the customer is behaving. Okay, suppose we have posted one poster. Now here we need to understand how the customer behavior is. What is the open rate? For example, for email marketing, if you go, here you will analyze how many people are opening, at what time they are opening, on what clicks they are opening. So these are analytics. There is a different field that is called as digital marketing analytics. So these are some of the different fields of digital marketing. Now, what are the opportunities in digital marketing? So by learning digital marketing, you can become a professional blogger. Okay, nowadays, this one also blogging, it is a trending one. Okay, people are earning from 3 to 4 lakhs, that too per month. So next one is, yes. So earn with affiliate marketing and AdSense. So here by using AdSense, that I told, by blogging is there, or some of your website is there. Once the traffic comes to your website, you can use AdSense and monetize your website. And affiliate marketing, as I told, you need to sell others Amazon products. Based on that, you will get some commission. So you can start as a freelancing service. So if you learn this means, you can start giving a freelancing service. Nowadays, the freelancers required are there also. Company wants some expert in digital marketing people. You can begin your own digital marketing agency, or you can start your own digital marketing agency. You can become a YouTuber, and now drop shipping. So this one also, as I told, it's also similar to affiliate marketing, but here you will you will have one website. Okay, you will take products from someone, and you will sell those products. So now next thing is content writer. So here it one for you need to create the content for a company or for a website. Okay. And then you can become a social media marketing expert, or you can also become SEO specialist. So these are the opportunities which are available in digital marketing. Now coming to what are the roles and the responsibilities of a digital marketer. So the basically digital marketer, what he will do is he will develop, implement and manages online marketing campaigns. So he only creates one campaign, okay, and he implements that one and he manages. So by using this, what he will do, he will promote a product or service of a company. Okay, so by this he will create brand awareness. So basically what he will do, he will develop, implement and manages online marketing campaigns. So to promote products or services of a company. So then he will create a brand awareness. So that's what the develop and manage digital marketing campaigns. Then he will manages the organization's website. So he'll be giving one website, so that he need to take care. And he need to optimize the content for the website and social networking channels such as Facebook, Twitter, Instagram, and track the website traffic flow and provide internal reports regularly. So you may be using Google Analytics for this one. So you can understand what all are the traffic coming from where it is coming. So he need to analyze that one and provide internal reports. So fix any error in online content and arrange webinars and webcasts. Next, what you do means you will identify new digital marketing trends and ensure that the brand is in front of the industry developments. And then work on SEO of the website pages. Now edit and post the content, videos, podcasts, and audio content on online sites. Promote companies' product and services in the digital space. So you execute social media efforts to improve key performance indicators. So KPIs. KPIs means key performance indicators, such as likes, shares, tweets, the number of conversions, impressions. So next, creating and executing SMS and email-based marketing campaigns. So these are all the roles and responsibilities of a digital marketer. So what he has to do, he needs to develop, implement, and manage online marketing campaigns. Then he needs to manage organization's website. He needs to optimize the content and track the website traffic flow and fix any error in online content. And he needs to identify any new digital marketing trends. Okay, so and then work on SEO of the website pages, edit and post content, videos, podcasts. So promote companies, product and services. And then he needs to monitor the KPIs, shares, tweets. And then he need to do SMS and email marketing campaigns. Now, given below are some digital marketing jobs available in India. So you can go to these portals, naukri.com, Times Jobs, Shine, Monster. So now you can type content marketing means you will get some 35,000 jobs are there in Naukri and 26,500 in Times Jobs. And in Shine, you will find 61,000. And Monster, you will find 18,540. So now what is the salary for a content marketing? He can earn somewhere from 18,000 to 1 lakh. Depending upon the experience, it will vary. As a fresher, he may get into from 10 to 15,000 salary. Okay. And thereby in mid-level, we can say he may get 30 to somewhere around 60,000. So among after 5 years, he may get from 70,000 to till 1 lakh. Or depending upon the performance, so you can get more also. And now coming email marketing. So for now, grade is 3,693 is there. In Times Jobs, 31,000 jobs are there. And for coming about the salary, so he can earn from 15,000 to 25,000. And for social media marketing, the average salary will be 15,000 to 35,000. And for SEO marketing, it is from 12,000 to 35,000 he can earn. And for digital marketing manager, he may earn 30,000 to till 1.5 lakhs. So these are some digital marketing jobs which are available in India. So now, what are the core skills required for a digital marketing? So what skills a digital marketer require? First one is analytical ability. Analytical ability means he need to understand from the customer behavior. So how he is responding to the campaigns, and you need to understand for example, in email marketing, how many number of opening of email and on which link they are going to click. And by Google Analytics, we can understand from which locations we are getting the customers. So this he need to do analysis. So that ability you should have, that is called as analytical ability. Next one is communication or interpersonal skills. You should have very good communication skills. Okay, so because he needs to sometimes need to interact with the customers, and he needs to have sales skills. He should be a tech savvy. Tech savvy means he needs to understand the technology. He should use the technology, and basic design skills. Okay, and video and image editing skills, and then content creating. So optional skills you may like see as HTML, JavaScript, CSS. Cascaded sheets, it will come. Cascaded side sheets. So at last we will see like digital marketing career tree. So in this much is so first you can enter at is a digital marketing intern or copywriter, okay? Then you become a digital marketing executive, okay? Then here we can find SEO is there, web developer, web designer, digital designer, content editor, social media executive, email executive. So after this, then you can become email automation manager, social media manager, content manager, or you can become UX manager, SEO account manager, paid media account manager, affiliates or partnership manager. Then once you gain the experience, you will move to some head, okay, like head of affiliates, head of paid media, head of SEO, creative director, head of like content. So now head of social media. So on the above, he will be head of digital marketing. Okay. For example, if you are here means in this position, like you need some consistency and attention to detail. If you are here, you need to have like time management and idea generation. And if you are in this position means you need to have management and reporting skills. If you are here, you need to have leadership and innovation skills. Okay. So this is the career graph of digital marketing. Okay, thank you.